This video is co-sponsored by graphicstock.com. Hey guys, welcome back to Creatnprocess, and today we are here again to create another very amazing logo designing. But before we go further, there is a special offer for you guys. Graphicstock.com is offering 7 days free trial to their website. So there's a huge library of content available for download royalty free, which will include images, pattern, textures, icons, buttons, background templates. You can download over 300,000 images. The interesting stuff which I found here is icons and the buttons. If you go to icons, you've got a whole list of vector library which can be useful while creating infographics, banners, ads. Few of the interesting stuff which I found here is compass vector, infographics, modern style infographics, and I can download it in various formats like JPEG, PNG, PDF, vector. So a few more stuff which I found here is vector globe in different views which I can use in various projects. There's one more, vector glass globe. So I found all these. You can just go and check out the website, or you can click the link in the description for free trial. So let's go ahead and design our logo. Today we'll be designing this logo. This logo has got a very unique style. It is basically hand drawn. Each layer has been drawn out with hand and has got different flow. There are three layers. Each layers apply with different colors, yellow, blue and orange. So to design this logo, we'll use the pencil tool and draw out it with our hand. And after that, with the help of die selection tool and handle tool, we'll tweak it out the corners. So let's begin the tutorial. First I'll draw the blueprint of the shape using the ellipse tool. So I'll just draw the circle, and after that fill it up with the stroke color, change the stroke color to something else, and draw a line segment from here around. And after that I'll just select both, and with the shape builder tool I'll just subtract the stop piece, and selecting the delete these corners pieces, and we're left with this. So with the help of direct selection tool, I just select this and push it up to this, giving it some length to the cup. And with the direct selection tool, with the handle tool, just make sure to maintain this flow. So if you look at it, now we got that shape. Now after that, I'll just select this and rotate this to tilt this to an angle like that and place it there. Now I can just scale it down a little bit like that and place it there. Now next thing we need to do is lock this up, Control 2. Now we are ready to draw it. So I select the pencil tool, increase the stroke thickness to around 3, change the stroke color to something else, and let's draw it out. So let's draw it out from here, giving that flow. Control Z if you, and just concentrate on drawing that. Just go here, giving that nice flow to the handle, and now just draw it out like this, zigzag. Keep on drawing that, continue drawing it until it's formed that, and we'll need to draw it out until it's fill up the hole space. And you need to maintain that shape inside, you need to draw it out inside this blueprint, and keep on drawing and finish it when it's finished. Now you got that. Now we need to draw two more. So with the selection tool, select the different colors, now blue, and let's draw it out with the pencil tool again. I'll draw it out from here, giving that flow, giving that, finishing it from here, and let's go ahead. So from here, giving that flow, maintain this shape, volume, and keep on drawing it out. Okay, like that. Okay, you're getting it. And we need to make sure that the corners are round, so you need to maintain that. So just go there and just keep on drawing and make sure they are round, and finish it around here like that. So let's check it out. Okay, that's good and good. Now last piece, we need to draw it out. Let's change it to something different colors, like let's change to yellow, and let's draw it out. So with the pencil tool, we'll start from here and let's go along with that, and let's draw it out, maintaining that flow. Keep the corners round, keep on making it round. And after here, what I'll do here next is I'll just go along with this curve and make sure it maintains the shape. And after that, just draw a few more curves from here, giving that nice flow to this, like that, and with this, we'll finish this up to here. So let's check it out. Okay, that's good. So let's tweak it out now. So if I go here, you can see there are lots of corners here. You can see there are lots of sharp corners. We need to make that corner round. So we'll start it from one side. So I'll just go here and select this and make sure to make it round. Make it round like that and push it inside, maintaining that flow like that. This one, we need to make it round. So select this with the handle tool, maintain the curve like that. This one, we have one more handle, so just go and tweak it out like that, giving that sharp corner round like that. Select the handles and keep on making the corners round like that. With that, you can get a nice round corners here. Here we need to do a little adjustment. Select this, make it round. This one, where's the handle? Let's change the handle color to something else. I'll go to layer, double click on this, and I'll change this to something else which I can see. Let's like green and click OK. So now we can see the handles, like select this, and here we can see it. Just make sure to maintain its flow like that. Move it around like that, giving that flow to this. Okay, then we can just check it out. Okay, that's good. Now let's look at it overall. First thing, the yellow should be on the top, so let's fill this up with the perfect color first. So selecting this, I'll change the color to yellow with the eye picker. I select this yellow color and fill it up with the stroke color. Select the other piece, selection tool, eye picker, select this color, V, invert the color to stroke color. Last piece, select this with the eye picker, select the orange color, invert the color to stroke, and now select all of them and increase the stroke thickness to 4. Let's check it out. Okay, we can reduce it, but let's remove this first. Ctrl+Alt+2 and delete this blueprint, and I'll just bring it back here and I'll just scale this down a little bit and I'll just keep this 3.5. let's check it out. Okay, that's good. We can reduce a little bit more, 3.2. okay, that's good. Now the blue is arranged to the front, and on top of that I'm keeping the yellow, so the orange is on the back side. So if you check it out, that's good. And here we can give some flow here. You can see there are some little bit of needed adjustment here, so select that and let's push it inside. While selecting the vertices, you can just go there and play with the handles and let's push it inside here so that the flow is maintained. And okay, let's check it out now. Okay, that's good. You can give that nice curve here, so we can just select these handles and we can give that. So just select this, push this out a little bit more, selecting that, pushing it out, maintain that flow as well. In the same way, select this, just select it and place it here and just maintain the flow. Here, selecting that, I can just increase this and I just extend this point to here, giving that flow. Okay, select it and increase it to here, place it there. and with the handle selected, I can just check it out. Okay, this one, make sure to maintain the flow as well, like that. So that's good. Here I got a sharp point here, you can just go there and do the adjustments like that, with the handle selected like that. So overall, we have achieved the design which we wanted. It's totally hand-drawn, so it's going to be like this. But hand-drawns are basically very unique, and it's always great to do some stuff like this. So if you check it out, it's looking good. Now only final thing which you need to hear is the text. So I'll just type out a text. T-A-N-G-L-E-D, Tangled. Let's change the color to white and scale this up a little bit, and I'll just change the font to Dalinia UPC. So with the IP card, just select this and it's done. I'll just go to character, and I've given some alphabet distance. Let's increase to 300. Let's check it out and increase the font size to around this much, and let's go here. I'll just make this bold. Check it out. Okay, that's good. We can increase this or decrease this a little bit according to that. Giving, let's list this, push this up a little bit, and I'll just place it here. And let's check it out. We can increase the alphabet distance here, just make it 500 and check it out. Okay, that's also good, but we need to reduce the font size here. So we got the design, we have added alphabet, text, and finally we have completed our logo. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Also, you can click the link in the description for a free trial. Thank you.